Hi, this is Jaya. Now we shall see the summary of Please Look After Mom by Kyung Suk Shin. Now Kyung Suk Shin is actually a South Korean writer, and this story also was first written in South Korean, Korean language. And the story is about the disappearance of the mother and how her four children and her husband, they think about their relationship with their mother and what all the mother has done for them. And this novel is translated in English by Chi Young Kim. And the full novel is about how guilty the children feel for not taking good care of their mother and thinking about the sacrifices the mother has done for the children and for the family. And it's also about how when the people come from a village and when they come and settle down in a city, how they forget their family rituals slowly and get used to the city life. And throughout the novel, it is as though each one is speaking to us. And it is a narration by all the four children and even by the husband and finally by the mom herself. Actually, what happens is in the railway station in Seoul, Seoul is one of the busy cities in South Korea. Park So-nyo, she is the mom. She is 69 years old and she has she is the mother of four children. And she is an illiterate mother. She gets lost because her husband absentmindedly leaves her in the railway station. And when they come back, they do not find her. Now, she is an illiterate person who cannot read or write. And she does not know the social behavior in a city. And so they don't know, because the novel starts at the time of the novel's beginning, it is shown as though the mother is missing for nearly a week. So now after a week, since they are not able to trace where she is, they start thinking that they will never be able to get her back. And immediately what they do is, because for 1 week they have waited, and what they do is, the moment they find that their mother has not come back, they make posters and they stick all over the city informing that if anyone sees her, please contact this number and all that. And now what happens is, the eldest son first, his name is Hong Choi, he starts thinking about how throughout his life his mother has encouraged him and made him to excel in his studies, and then afterwards how she has encouraged him to become a big person in the social and economic status. And today he is a very successful business person in Seoul. Being a successful business person in Seoul is a great thing, because Seoul is one of the richest cities also. And he's thinking like, why I didn't go to the railway station to pick them up? How can I think that small... Now he's thinking like, after the mother is lost, how can I think that people from village, how coming to a metropolitan city, how can they find their place, the way, and come to his house? He feels very guilty for not going to the railway station. And more than that, when his mother was lost, he was taking a spa day. And so he's thinking, how when my mother was suffering there, I was enjoying here. And he thinks that how many sacrifices the mother has done for him. Like, they were very poor, and the mother was the only hardworking member in the family. And she used to even skip a food to give him food. She never used to eat, but she used to feed them. And what happened is, just to bring up her bring up the children, she used to do all sorts of works. And she worked in the rice paddy fields, and she did so many menial jobs which were paid very less, but that little money also they needed. And afterwards she encouraged the children to come to the city and settle down, but she will not come. Like, she'll come there, she'll stay for some time, and even in that some time she'll be doing all the housework for them. And afterwards she'll say, no, I can't be here for a long time because I have to go and work in the field, and they will, and she will go off. But it is a lie that everyone knows, because she knew that only at that time, this is earlier when they shifted to the Seoul city, she didn't want to be a burden to them. She understood that city life is a very costly life, and she did not want to be a burden to them. So she'll tell them, no, I have work in the village, and she'll go off. And even the children, they were very selfish, they were very stingy. they did not, though they have taken everything from the mother, they did not want to give her anything. Like when she comes, they made her to do all the chores in the house. And when she says, okay, I want to go back to the field, they were very happily sending her back. Though they did not say it, they preferred only her short visit. She has to come do some work for them and go. And now what happened is, now the mother is missing for so many days. And all her sacrifices are coming into his mind. And from the age of 17, Sonia, that is her mother's name, she has been only working and nothing else. She knows only to work. Then the story is again narrated by her eldest daughter, Chihan, and who is staying again in the same city and living a very luxurious life. And she thinks all this is only because of the sacrifices her mother has done. Because now she is a very famous novelist. And all that education and interest in writing all came only because of the sacrifices her mother has done for her. And she remembers how hard her mother has worked for very little money in the different sorts of shows. And she thinks that when her mother was lost, she was in a book fair in Beijing, and everyone around her were praising her for the for her writing in the book. And she thinks how people will be very unkind to her mother, because her mother will look very sick and filthy, and even she'll wear very cheap shoes, and blood and pus will be pouring from her feet and all that. See, when we are reading this, we should understand that the children are in a well-settled position, and if the mother is going to be like this, means it only shows that they have never taken care of the mother. They never saw to it that the mother should be comfortable, and the mother is still living the same simple, not even simple, below than simple, a very very grudgy life, where her dress will be filthy, her shoes will be very cheap. Whereas we find that her elder son is one of the most successful business person, and the eldest daughter is a successful novelist, but they never wanted to give money to their parents. This is all is evident when we are seeing when all this description about the mother being sick, filthy, wearing cheap shoes and all that. And now Chihan thinks about the sacrifices her mother has done, because from her young age she wanted to become a writer, and so she wanted to read the famous books. And when she wanted to read a book by Nietzsche, her mother had sold their puppy to buy her that book. And even when she wanted to get educated in college, in spite of being poor, her mother encouraged her. She even went to the extent of selling her wedding ring, and she made her to study. But she has only called her mother very few times, and that also only to take care of her. But she has never taken care of her mother, and she thinks very bad, because her mother was complaining about severe headaches, but even then she never bothered to take her mother to the hospital. And about that, she feels very guilty. Chihan is now feeling very guilty that she has never repaid her mother or taken good care of her mother. And they now the children all start thinking that their mother has lived a very 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 sad life, and they are to be blamed for that, for not taking good care of the mother. Now next we find the husband telling the story, and he thinks that he has been very cruel to the mother all this time. And he now, after missing his wife, he understands how much he loves his wife, and at the same time how much sacrifice she has done for the family and for him. And he wants to say thank you to her. He wants to thank her for all the sacrifices they have done in their life. And he even thinks about how at one time he fell in love with another woman, and he even brought her home. And Sono got so angry that she went out of the house. But then Sono understood that she is the only person who is hardworking in the family, and if she is not there in the family, all of them will suffer. And for the sake of the children, she comes back, and she asks him and her lover to leave the house. And he was very glad to leave the house and go out with his lover. But after months, what happened is that woman who came as his lover, she dumped him and she went out, and he had no other place to go. So he came back to the family, and Sono, just for the sake of the family, she forgave him and she allowed him to come into the family. Like this, each of them, they think about how they have been very inhuman to their mother. And then what happens is, suddenly one person, his name is Hong Toi Hee, he is the director of an orphanage. Seeing this posters, he comes there and he tells the children that Their mother, in spite of all the poverty, in spite of all the hard work and all that, she has always donated a small amount to the orphanage. Whenever she gets any amount, she'll come and donate to the orphanage. And she has also been a volunteer regularly. And this shows what a great human their mother had been. He sees the poster and he comes, and when he says this only, they also realize that their mother has been helping orphan people's children. And then what happens is, finally we find that the mother itself speaks to us in the novel, and she says that she has done throughout her life, she has done all this because she wanted more for the family. She wanted all her children to settle down very nicely, though she knew that her husband was a very ungenerous person and he treated her very cruelly. And though she knows that her children have been very stingy children, they didn't want to give her anything, they didn't want to take care of her. But she has always made everyone think that she has a very caring family, and she has also lived a very careful life. And only in the end of the novel, through the mother, we come to know that months ago she was diagnosed with terminal cancer, that is the final stage of cancer. And the novel ends with the elder daughter Chihon traveling through Italy with her boyfriend Yubin. But as she's traveling, she's thinking about her mother because the mother is still not found. And then she thinks that she can only pray for her mother because she cannot repay her in any way. She has not done it earlier and she's feeling guilty about it. And so she starts praying for her mother. And when she is praying, she remembers her mother praying for her mother. That is, her mother praying for Chihon's grandmother. So she thinks that every daughters have this habit of praying for the mother. And it is also evident from the story that every children, they do not take care of their mom as they should take. There may be exceptions, but mostly it doesn't have. So that is the title of the novel. Please Look After Mom is just, it's like the prayer where Chihon is doing, but it is a message which the writer is giving to the readers that please take care of your mom. It's not a prayer. It is a command saying it is your duty. You have to take care of your mother. Because throughout the life, a mom sacrifices a lot for the children. But the children never realize it. They realize it only after they have lost their parents. And what is the use of realizing it after you lose your mom? So they say take care of your mom. This is the command from the writer. I hope you've understood the story. Please like the video. Share it with your friends. And if you've not subscribed my channel, please subscribe. Thank you.